Good morning, everyone. It's Yvonne here from the Aussie Goddess to do the the light just dimmed as I did that to do your weekend what's cracking. Thank you so much for subscribing to my channel, for your beautiful comments and such generosity with your love. I'm so grateful to be on this journey. I don't know, it feels funny when people thank me because I think it's something that I love to do. If you're interested in having a personal reading, doing life coaching with me, or joining me for some classes, I have two classes going ahead in April and May. So one of them is obviously tarot teaching, which I get asked to do all the time. And the other one will be on, I guess, relationships, narcissism, empathy, and the twin flame journey. If you're interested in any of those, whip over to the Aussie Goddess Facebook page. Everything is pinned to the top of the page, so you'll find out what I'm doing, where I'm going. If you're unsure, you can email me. I don't have a problem with emails. I am going live tomorrow on Facebook at 10 a.m. Australian Eastern Daylight Time. I do an hour. If you get in, you get in. If you don't, my apologies up front. I do as many as I can in that short period of time. And we often have quite a few people come over for that one. 13th, 14th next week, of course, I'm in Bathurst. I did a little bit of a, I guess, a TV read for some of the people that came on to watch the other day, which was super. I want to also say thank you to a couple of people who've been so incredibly generous with me. And I want to say thank you for your generosity and your thoughts. And you know who you are, so, okay. Did I say I'm using the Wizard's Tarot? And catch me on TikTok now. I do a daily dip on TikTok now, so if you want to just catch a quick daily energies. All right, I've just got out of the shower and I'm really, that's why I'm blotchy. I've got a lot to do today and I don't know, I've been up since four and I've been meandering, wasting time wasting, whatever you like to call it. I managed to have one cup of coffee. All right, let's get into it. Enough gabbering on. Oh, look at the beautiful Knight of Pentacles coming through here. I have a little bit of a soft spot for the old Knight of Pentacles. He's such a slow, ploddy person. Can represent Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. This is somebody coming in with an offer. Pentacle can represent something more tangible, like a job, money. I love how time's in the background of this one because he is slow. There's always that sort of feeling that you've been waiting forever for something to happen. If you've been waiting a long time, you might still have a bit more of a wait here when this little guy shows up, because there is still more time to pass before he can reach his destination. I think, like me, he's probably stopped to admire the view. Sit and have a picnic. All right, so we have the Page of Wands behind that. So somebody's feeling pretty sort of passionate and revved up here. This is often sort of passion at its best with the page, but we're talking messages here. It may not be a strong offer. It may just be a little bit of a touch base, how you're going sort of message coming through. If you're looking for a job, and you're waiting for somebody to contact you about work, a course, education, and somebody's been very slow getting back to you, I wouldn't worry, because whatever is coming here feels good to me. There is a feeling of that sort of fiery energy coming through with this card. So, all right, so we have the Four of Wands coming through. And the Four of Wands in this deck shows a mirror image of someone else. It's not the person looking in the mirror. And I particularly love the deck for this reason. Because I feel that this person is either looking at the mirror at somebody he sees as his twin, who then, male, female, regardless, the energies are still the same. Or it could be somebody looking and anticipating something in their future. So it could be that you're anticipating somebody coming towards you here. But the Four of Wands is a card that does talk of twin flames, but it also talks about stability, marriage, long-term commitment. I feel very strongly that somebody maybe already has their eye on you or has been keeping an eye on you. Wow, because look, you may be the one that got away here. You may be the person that somebody looks at as the one that got away. Life's too short to let that one go, but people do. And I've seen it with people, you know, 20, 30 years, and I think that's a long time, isn't it, to do without something that you love. But there's somebody here who feels that you are the one that got away. The Empress is a card that talks about, I mean, it's the ultimate beauty card. It's the ultimate inner outer beauty. It's the energy to create. She represents like Mother Earth and Lady Gaia. She's really full of life, full of love, and just absolutely beautiful. And I think quite unaware of her beauty here. Oh my goodness, she has a cat, and I've never noticed that before. Feminine energy. All right, so we have then the Queen of Wands. So some of you, wow, okay, this is a love offer coming. This is a love offer that's coming here. Look at that. Ace of Cups. For some of you, it could be a creative project, a creative job. But I feel like for many of you here, you've been waiting for some sort of love offer. I feel that you're waiting because you feel very, very passionate about whatever this is, whoever this person is. Somebody's coming in to offer you some sort of long-term commitment, long-term relationship here, because they see that you got away here. They want to look at this. They see you as the Queen of Wands. You could be dealing with a Leo, Sag, or Aries. You could be dealing with someone that you find equally as attractive here. But this person certainly feels they've missed out on something. And with that Page of Wands, they're quite passionate about it as well. All right, so we have the Devil coming out. So you could be dealing with a Capricorn. But the Devil card talks about extremes, ego, things that feed your ego. This can be obsession, addiction, codependency, which of course is addiction to people, love addiction. Anything that really is more than possibly what you should be really doing or being. It's the extremes of things. But the Devil card is an ego card. And, you know, while we all need our ego, I know sometimes people say, oh, get rid of your ego. You're never going to get rid of your ego. There are parts of your ego that serve you, and that's why we have one. But there are certainly negative parts of your ego or parts that you do not need that you could let go of. So something in this card here, you could be dealing with someone who's been in this energy and unable to move forward because of their ego. So you could have someone, for example, that is not moving forward or making an offer at this time because maybe they're worried about what other people might think. Maybe they are immersing themselves here in their own stuff. Maybe you're dealing with someone who is a little narcissistic here, a little bit self-focused. But something about this Devil card today, that's a little different to normal. I'll pick up the energies while I'm reading the next card. Okay, all right, we have the Eight of Wands, the Six of Wands. Okay, so somebody might be wanting to feed their ego now. King of Cups. Maybe somebody's realizing you do make them feel better about themselves here. And especially if you're dealing with someone who has a little bit of that sort of tendency to look at things from that the perspective of what makes me look good. Let's be a little bit cautious here. A little bit cautious. You may be dealing with a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. I sort of get this energy that somebody wants victory at all costs here. And I feel like maybe they're being, or they're attracted to you because somehow or another they feel you might make them look better. Getting very much that sort of energy coming through. All right, let's have a look where we're going. We have the Ace of Wands. Somebody is very, very physically attracted to you here, Queen of Wands. Nine of Cups coming through. That's interesting. All right, with the Two of Swords. Well, the Nine of Cups, I can't deny that the Nine of Cups isn't a wish card, but is it this person's wish coming towards you? Is it your wish to have contact from this person? There's a really strange energy coming through at the moment with this, and I want to dig a little bit deeper. This person's making some sort of choice to come towards you. They want a new start. And this often sort of denotes a very physical attraction. But the Ace of Cups was here, so I do think that there is love here. I do. But somebody's worried about their image here more than anything. That's what's coming through very, very strongly. But then I'm seeing the other side of it, and I feel like you're really, this is something you really want here with the wish card. But are you being somewhat sort of deceived or, I don't know, led astray or something? Let me keep going with it. Maybe this person's just really passionate and coming across as loving. We do have the Magician here. So somebody has stepped into their power. And we do have the Judgment card. So for some of you, this could be someone returning. All right, and we have the Seven of Swords coming through. That doesn't help the energy I'm getting with the Devil here. I feel like somebody's doing something for their own benefit rather than for the good of the relationship or the good of the union or good of the connection. I don't always get that with that Devil energy, but today it's coming through very strong. And then I have the Seven of Swords here. Now, the Seven of Swords is a bit the same in that I can feel it in a different energy sometimes. But today it's coming across like somebody's pursuing you for their own benefit, not for yours. So there's a strong feeling of codependency, a strong feeling of someone who may be a little bit self-interested. And that doesn't sound like true love to me. It sounds like love of self, love of the ego. This person could be somebody you've already known with the Judgment card here, but I actually am feeling even a different energy with the Judgment card here, because I'm strongly feeling with this Judgment card that there's a little bit of an awakening on your side here, like a bit of a realization and some choice you're making here. Let me just get into it a little bit deeper. Somebody looks like they've been taking their time coming towards you. Somebody who's very ready to sort of make this union a real thing. I feel like this person's either been keeping an eye on you or knows that you have a very strong connection here. Perhaps somebody feels that you were the one that got away. Maybe you've not had a physical relationship with this person before. Now, it could be that on your end, you're feeling love for this person too, but maybe this isn't reciprocated or it's not what you expected it to be. Let me just get some more clarification here. If this person isn't coming in for that, that's the way they are presenting in the cards here. That is the way they're coming across, with a very, like a self-determination, but not a healthy one. Like, I need to win at all costs. I need this. I want this. I want this to be mine. But it's not a, I love this person. I want to be able to give them, you know, whatever I have of me. It's almost like a very, it could be that they're so taken, Five of Wands jumping out here. It could be that they're so fascinated by you, especially with that Queen of Wands energy. If you're coming up Queen of Wands Empress, they could be quite drawn to your energy, but maybe not really know you very well. So it may be that they're really craving the physical attention rather than the attraction. Very interesting here. This person is definitely trying to manifest something with you here. But I feel strongly. Okay, so we have coming through the Six of Cups, which gives, gives more rise to the fact that somebody hears from your past. Ten of Pentacles, someone sees you as the ultimate gift. They see you as their abundance. Queen of Cups coming through here. So I do have the Queen and the King. So you have a very strong connection here without any doubt whatsoever. All right, let's just get another card. Seven of Pentacles. You could be dealing with someone who has other options. You could be dealing with someone who sees you as an option, but it's like I've got to have that. I feel like you're that prize. I do with the Ten of Pentacles. It's almost like you're a prize for them. They want to win it. They want to be successful in this. I feel that maybe with this person, you're feeling with the Ace of Cups that you're getting what you want here. But there is a very, very strong feeling here. This is going to send you in a slightly different direction here with this person. I feel like there's some sort of wake-up call coming here and a decision that needs to be made. So this is very Knight of Wandsy energy, where somebody just wants to physically win you over. I feel like for you, this is sort of something either you've been waiting for or wishing for, but I feel like here you're dealing with someone who's extremely self-centered, who really doesn't have your best interests at heart, which says it can't possibly be true love, because this person is just wanting to win at all costs here. But I feel like it's really good for you if you're dealing with this person, or this person is on their way to you, this is really good for you, because I feel that you're seeing through some sort of illusion here. You're seeing through something that you've never seen before. So maybe you had this person on a pedestal. Maybe you thought that they were something they weren't. And you're about to see them come through with this sort of true face. But this person is definitely trying to manifest something physical here. So there's communication coming through. But this could definitely be some sort of connection. It's Six of Cups, King and Queen of Pentacles, King and Queen of Cups here. It's like you have some sort of maybe a lesson to learn or some sort of wake-up call with the Judgment card here. Maybe you've been seeing things from the wrong perspective. Very interesting. Okay, we have Mother Mary coming through. Nurture yourself. Okay, sorry, we're using the Ascended Masters today. This is one of my first decks, actually, which I think is quite lovely. You've given a lot of yourself lately, and now it's time to give something to yourself. You've drawn this card because you need to nurture yourself. This means taking good care of your body through sleep, detoxification, and exercise. It also means taking care of your needs as you would for others. To have more energy, abundance, peace, purpose, and everything you desire, nurture yourself. I really feel that this is probably saying to you, you need to look at yourself in this situation. What do you want? Are you getting what you want? Be the observer here. Don't get into the emotion of it all. Don't get taken up in that. Unless that's what you want. You know, at the end of the day, you know, if you just want a purely physical connection with someone, that's your choice. But what I'm saying here is just if you want more, if your intention is to have something more deep and meaningful, then I'd be looking at it a little bit differently. I'd be definitely being the observer here and watching and asking the questions. Because the one thing you don't want here is to end up with your heart broken because you wanted something and the other person didn't. Because the physical aspect of a relationship doesn't last very long. The other side, the intellectual, the emotional, those things, you've got a chance of having something long term if that's what you want. But anyway, I'll leave you with that. Thanks.